Top 10 VPN lists are everywhere, but let's be honest, most of them include VPN providers that barely deserve a mention. So this time, instead of compiling a huge best VPN 2025 list, I reviewed more than 20 options and picked the elite three that truly deliver. Now, I didn't choose them on a whim. I had strict requirements. I made sure each VPN had a proper, independently audited no-logs policy and features to keep my data private and secure. I also wanted to see top-tier performance metrics, so I ran VPN speed tests and checked streaming and torrenting support. I had quite a few usability requirements as well, and of course, a good VPN shouldn't break the bank, so I looked at the prices too. I admit this is a pretty extensive list, but we're looking for the best VPN 2025, not just some mid-tier passable stuff. So, three VPNs managed to check all of the boxes: Proton VPN, Surfshark, and NordVPN. I'm not gonna lie, I was not surprised. These are already known as the top dogs in the VPN market. But I do have to warn you in terms of their price. They tend to hide their best discounts, and to unlock them, you need to get coupon codes. If you want to pay the lowest price, I'll leave links to the current best deals in the description down below, and I'll keep them updated. That said, you don't need all three VPNs, and let's be fair, they're not all perfect at everything. So let's go through each and see what they're best fit for and what are some of their drawbacks. Starting with a short NordVPN review 2025, to me, NordVPN is the ultimate pick if you need to use a VPN often and for various purposes. It is the most universal app out of the three best VPNs and honestly, my go-to for a long time now. I say it's universal because NordVPN is currently the fastest VPN provider out there, and in my VPN speed tests, it had the highest speed retention. The reason behind it is the NordLynx protocol. Almost every other VPN out there uses WireGuard, and NordLynx is an upgraded version of that, so go figure. Anyway, the great speeds make NordVPN a great fit, not just for private browsing, but for streaming and torrenting too. I'd even go as far as to say it's the best VPN for streaming. I use it for this all the time, and I rarely encounter an issue. It does happen sometimes, but usually all it takes to fix it is switching a server or clearing a cache. And then you can enjoy whatever content you want, as NordVPN has servers in more than 110 countries. Should be 118 now. A few days ago, it was 113, and sure, it's good that they're growing, but oh my god, the server count changes all the time. I can't get a break. Anyway, one thing you might notice about NordVPN app is that there are a lot of features here. While some are very specific, like onion over VPN for maximum online anonymity, there's good stuff for everyday use too. My favorite thing is Threat Protection Pro. It used to be just an ad and tracker blocker, but now it warns you about malicious websites and then even scans your download files for malware. Yep, similarly to an antivirus. They even got an evaluation from the AV Test Institute itself, and compared to other similar VPN features, Threat Protection Pro showed the best threat detection rates. I also want to mention MeshNet. It's a very unique feature that lets you link devices for stuff like file sharing or remote LAN parties. However, not gonna lie, the setup can be a bit of a pain. One more bone I have to pick with NordVPN is the fact that their Linux app has no GUI. Like, come on guys, how long will I have to complain about this? But yeah, if you're searching specifically for a Linux VPN, I'd suggest choosing between Surfshark and Proton VPN. Otherwise, NordVPN is a great VPN choice. That said, how much will you pay for it? While NordVPN isn't the cheapest VPN out there, it's still pretty affordable, especially if you choose the long-term plans. Plus, if you only need the VPN and nothing else, there's also a cheaper basic plan. As I mentioned, to get the best price, you need a coupon, which you can grab via this QR code or check the description. In my view, NordVPN can handle whatever task you throw at it, be it streaming, torrenting, or private browsing. So yeah, it's a great VPN for everyday use and definitely worth a try. But what if you don't need a VPN that often and you want to pay less too? Then I suggest looking into Surfshark. If we do a quick Surfshark review, it offers solid privacy protection when browsing, can get through to pretty much any streaming library, and torrenting as well. But the best part about Surfshark, it is cheap. In fact, it is one of the cheapest VPNs out there, especially with a promo code. Yet while other options with similar price points skimp on features or limit device connections, Surfshark does neither. You can use it on however many devices your heart desires. All right, I didn't tell you this, okay? But your Surfshark account, you know, can end up on your friend's PC or your sibling's phone without any restrictions. And if you make them pitch in for the cost, Surfshark can be the cheapest VPN ever. Okay, looking at the app, Surfshark has a straightforward interface and quite a lot of various tools. There's a selection of specialized servers for privacy enthusiasts, not to mention all the necessary features like kill switch for IP leak protection or split tunneling, just under its own special serious name. The Bypasser. Anyway, I also really like their Clean Web tool for blocking ads, trackers, and malicious sites. The Clean Web 2.0 version you get with the Surfshark browser extension even gets rid of cookies, pop-ups, and warns you if a website you're visiting has ever been breached. All of that comes with the cheapest plan. If you pick their mid-tier subscription, which is still cheaper than most other VPNs, it also adds a full-on antivirus. Not an antivirus-esque feature, no, no. A full-on antivirus anti-malware tool that can run full scans on your PC. Has ransomware protection, all the good stuff. It's even evaluated by AV Test, and their scores in the latest testing matched the current best antivirus results with 6 out of 6 points in protection. Of course, Surfshark isn't perfect. It's slightly slower than NordVPN, but still, thanks to its WireGuard protocol, it is the second fastest VPN that I've tested. Also, while Surfshark supports P2P, there are no special torrenting features here, so torrenters might want to look into the next best VPN 2025 candidate. But for streaming and overall casual VPN use, Surfshark is a solid option and incredibly cheap too. By the way, if you're finding this review useful, please consider subscribing and helping my small channel grow. Thanks. And now it's time for a Proton VPN review 2025. This VPN is an excellent choice for more advanced users. It stands out for its dedication to privacy and security and great business ethics. For starters, all Proton VPN apps are open source, meaning their source code is available for literally anyone to inspect. This ensures that there's no hidden tracking. Plus, the community can point out potential issues, making this VPN as secure as it can be. Proton as a company also had a very cool and unique start. It was founded by a scientist from CERN and then crowdfunded by activists. Now it's even moving to be a non-profit organization. So yeah, pretty damn cool. But let's look at the Proton VPN app itself. I already mentioned that it's one of the best VPN for torrenting pigs. It has servers optimized for torrenting, and in my best VPN testing, it showed some very solid speed retentions as well, mainly due to its VPN accelerator feature. But the main reason I recommend it for torrenting is port forwarding. A very rare feature that provides a more stable and faster P2P connection. While this specific tool is often deemed unsafe, Proton revamped it into a secure version that you won't find anywhere else. I also want to mention the advanced privacy tools you can get with this VPN. For one, just like NordVPN, Proton has a Tor network integration for maximum anonymity, as well as secure core servers. These are fully owned by the company and placed in high security data centers. So Proton is a privacy powerhouse, and that's great for advanced users. But on the flip side, for beginners, the app can feel a bit complicated and confusing. There are so many elements, settings, features, plus a map and special markers for servers. It's a lot, all right? And you'll likely not even need all of this stuff if you're a more casual user. In addition, this VPN can get a bit pricey. If you catch a deal with a coupon code, like the ones in the description, it's a bit more affordable. But generally, Proton is the priciest option of the best VPN 2025 picks. So now, with all three options covered, which VPN is the best for you? For everyday use, I recommend NordVPN due to its top-notch speeds. And yes, I'm a little biased since this is the VPN I use the most myself, usually for streaming. If you want to pay the least amount possible but still get a capable VPN, Surfshark's a great choice with unlimited connections as well. And for maximum transparency and the best torrenting experience, I recommend Proton VPN. I hope this best VPN 2025 breakdown was helpful, and let me know which VPN option you're using.